Hello, hello. It's Reds back with some more Space Marines. We are on our way to power up the Titan Invictus with some Chaos Energy. So we're going in there. We're gonna get stuff done. It's gonna happen.
But why?
Alone, there was no way the demon could get the
power. We're gonna do some work on some Chaos people.
It needed help.
And we obliged.
It's not gonna matter what they want to do. We're just gonna destroy them.
I am responsible for Chaos breaking through to this world.
This little area here is like full of things. I think there's Iron Halo is an extra shield. It powers up your shield. Helps you deal with the demons and the other new enemies in the game. Very useful. Highly recommend it. Two thumbs way up. Siskel and Ebert definitely recommend this. Like that looks terrible. I'm gonna go explore. Bam, right there. Found an audio log. And there's another one somewhere in here. I don't remember when I actually found it, but I think it was down this way. There's one like sneaking in a corner somewhere, trying to be not found. Crazy, somewhere else, yeah. Whatever.
Ultramarines, attack!
So this is going to be the introduction to a bunch of new enemies. We have the orcs on our right-hand side fighting against the forces of chaos on the left. And I decide to just go straight into the chaos side because they're new. We're just going to dive in and figure out what's up. That way the orcs won't attack us directly. It'll take a little more. Find that they have Chaos Marines right off the bat. So they're going to be the biggest problems in the coming areas, just as a heads up, because they are like Space Marines. They just do all the same things that Space Marines do. Excuse me, apologize. Squeaky chair, always. One day I'll get around to buying WD-40 for the chair. Who knows? I may not. Just enjoy the squeakiness too much. Makes things more endearing, I think. Who knows? So there's another little weapons cache here, and there's some audio logs around this area. I think I run around and find a few. I don't know. That's my one gripe about the Thunder Hammer. You can only use pistols, one-handed weapons.
Speak then.
You held the unshielded power source again, Captain.
But it's a trade-off because the Thunder Hammer is OP as hell.
Codex Astartes warns that those in league with Chaos can withstand the warp's touch.
You forget yourself, Ultramarine.
Leandros, I do not take this warp resistance lightly. But the search for answers must wait
till after we deal with this Chaos invasion.
What if that is too late?
Leandros, enough. We need to keep moving.
So there's the beginning of the trouble with that realization. Sidonis is kind of sticking up for us, because Sidonis, I guess, realizes that the issue at hand is much more important than questioning the situation. Because if they don't quell this invasion, then like the entire planet will be taken over, so on and so forth. Not good times. Not good times at all. So my initial prediction for Leandros does not appear to be holding out, but we'll see. There's still game left. I'm kind of doubting it at the moment. Religious fanatics are not easily turned, and I still kind of hold the Codex Astartes as a religious type thing. That's how it's easily describable to me, at least. You guys may completely disagree. Let me know in the comments if you disagree, you agree, you think it's silly, whatever. Just do the comments thing. I'm exploring here. Nothing amazingly exciting. There's a lot of I wouldn't say a lot, but comparatively, there's a decent amount of like running around and checking you can do if you want to find all the audio logs. I did not actually find them all. I missed quite a few, but I found enough to get an idea of the backstory. Just a way to pass along information that they don't pass along in the main story narrative. So you get things from the perspective of the characters. Space Marines versus a band of Chaos Marines. I actually get to a really low health at another point. I'm just trying to stun this guy and get his health. But I don't stun him in time, so I end up popping my Super Space Marine bow. These guys can do a lot of damage, the just normal soldiers. The damage they do will add up over time, so you gotta be careful about that. That's why you see me kind of rolling around trying to take them out. By little. I was actually trying to stun them and see if I can execute them for health, but it ended up not being possible. I was sad, because that would have been a really easy way to get a bunch of health. That guy's just standing in the middle of us. Did not know what was going on. Hanging out behind this pillar, taking him out, playing it kind of smart. I had to be careful about that, because he has a plasma launcher, I think. And it does splash damage and a good amount of it. So when he does take shots like that, I'm definitely trying to avoid it. Zigzag pattern. I think I actually dived over one. Just completely avoided it. No go over it. Could be wrong. Somebody have to go back and check. Give me your health. I just noticed that I executed him on the rail. Interesting enough. Trying to find a way down. Apparently, the giant well-lit rock slide was not enough of a clue. Because I missed it. I was trying to go down here. I figured they wouldn't put a wall up right there. There's no railing or anything. No railing there. So it should not matter. But they did. So I can't. And I was sad. And you can't even go down the giant rock slide because they have debris in the way.
My lord, help us!
So I grenade them right away. That's awesome. Demons! Thing. Shoulder rush that one to death.
Report. My lord, Space Marine. They were on us almost immediately.
Lieutenant. Captain Titus, are you there? This is Lieutenant Mira. This whole planet has gone mad.
The forces of Chaos are invading this world. We must get to the Titan and destroy that warp gate.
I know what route to take. I deployed troops to man outposts between the Calcus facility and Bastion Primus. From there, you can access the rail network and cross to Manufactorum Ajacus.
Understood. I will meet you there.
I don't know who is in charge of the naming schemes, but they're not easily remembered. I ate recently, so I'm catching the itis. Getting a little sleepy, so I'm gonna try and get around that. Okay, so we come to this giant battlefield. It was quite epic, just to watch. But, of course, as a Space Marine, you don't watch, you join in, and you win the battle. There's no question other than that. I think I'd take a death on this. It's been a while since I played it. You can't stop thinking about Arkham City. Looking so forward to that. I may, since I'm doing the pre-order from Best Buy, I get Robin for the challenge maps for free. So I might try the challenge out with him first if it's available right away. Because it's supposed to be a late November DLC release. So I don't know if they'll actually give us access to it for free or we'll just get a code to download it when it's released. If it is available, I'll probably do a challenge map or two and record it with Robin. And I'll put it as a feature. Just for the DLC. If it's not available, then I'll probably just wait, because I won't have a choice. Kind of hoping it's available early, because that would be really quick. That would make the pre-order even more worth it, because you're already, just for pre-order at Best Buy, you're probably saving like $6 or $7 for the DLC. I don't remember what it was exactly, but it was worth it. See if I can convince something into happening. So I'm not sure what the repercussions would be if it was discovered. But we'll see if I can work something delicious out so that I have double DLC or double pre-order bonus items. We'll find out. I'll let you guys know what I come down with. Video. For Arkham City. It's gonna be so good. I can't wait. So much to explore, so much to do, so many ways to kill bad guys, so many things to detect, so many gadgets to unlock. I'll probably have the most fun just exploring and trying to find all of the Riddler items. That was kind of the one of the bigger favorited things from Ark Asylum was just the exploration and finding all the Riddler's hidden question marks, hearing all the backstory and all that stuff. The interview tapes from Ark Asylum were pretty cool. Listening to the Joker corrupting Harley Quinzel, as Harley Quinn's actual name is, was kind of interesting. Psychology is an interesting one, so leads to cool situations. Okay, I was wondering, because I vaguely remember almost dying in this. I thought I might have died, but apparently not, because this is the last concentration of enemies. And I noticed my guys are shooting at something up here. Apparently I can just shoot through there, so it doesn't matter. But this video is coming to an end here shortly. I want to thank you all for joining me. Check back for some more episodes of Space Marines. Check back for more other series. This is Shreds, signing off. Catch you later.